even when you see me with somebody living better. I'm trying to tell you that me just doing me gonna have you jealous.
YouTube, Gucci Child boys and girls, we back with another video, man. Today, y'all see the title. Y'all see what we got. Oh, Lord. We got our boy Dax. And this song is called, well, Dear God. And as y'all can see by this question, it says, right, off rip, do you believe in God? As y'all know, I do. And, you know, I'm a Christian. I'm not like a, you know, I'm not in my Bible like crazy. But I definitely, you know, I'm definitely a Christian. I believe in the man upstairs. I believe in Jesus. I believe in good and evil spirits. I believe in all that. So, yeah. And angels, of course. Like, I believe in that, too. So, but I've always had questions and stuff. So, I wonder if Dax going to have the same questions I've had. So, anywho, without further freaking do, make it right to it. Okay, is Dax, it seemed like he reenacting, like, you know, what Jesus had to go through. Okay.
Just want to make this clear. I am a believer.
Okay.
But sometimes it gets hard.
I love the beat, by the way.
My name's Dax.
Dear God, there's a lot of questions that I have about the past. And I don't want to hear it from a human. You made it, so you're the last person that I'm ever going to ask.
Already. When I tell y'all I'm the same way, I'm literally the same way. Like, literally. I don't want to hear, like, from this person. I want to hear it from him. Oh, my God. Yeah, see, this might be a long video, y'all. Like, Dax, he already speaking facts.
And I don't want to hear it from a human. You made it, so you're the last person that I'm ever gonna ask. Tell me what's real, tell me what's fake. Why is everything about you a debate? What's the point of love? Every time I showed it, I was broken, and it's forced me just to only want to hate. Why is it only one you but multiple religions? Why does every conversation end in a division?
Oh my God, oh my God, y'all, that's the biggest. Oh my God, y'all, when I tell y'all, to this day, I remember, like, years ago, this question has still, like, been with me for the longest time. Literally years ago, like, when I was in middle school, I want to say, like, 7th, 8th grade. This is probably 8th grade. Mind y'all, I told y'all, like, you know, I'm a Christian. I was born in Christianity. Like, my whole family's Christians. Going to church faithfully every Sunday. Going to Bible study on Wednesday nights. And, you know, I always thought, like, Christianity was the only religion. But I think it was my social studies class that I was in 8th grade, the book, we were talking about history, and then the book, it had a lot of history in it, right? And one of the pages had, like, multiple other religions, because I saw Christianity, and I was like, hold on, wait. Why am I seeing Christianity, and then I'm seeing all these other things? What the heck? I saw Buddhism, I saw, what was it, Islam, something like that. And then I saw a whole bunch of other, I'm like, what is going on? And I've never really just wanted to ask, you know, obviously you can't ask a Christian family or people in your family that's Christian, because clearly they're going to tell you, like, you know, Christian is the only way and Christianity is the right and only way, you know? So I knew I can, you know, ask family about that. But that question has never left my mind ever since, y'all. And it's been, like, years now. I've had that question for, like, what, 10, 12 years now? So, yeah, like, Dax literally said it. Like, you know, there's one guy, why is it multiple religions? Because in my mind, y'all, like, I'm like, okay, I get there's multiple religions and everybody want to show each other respect. But everybody can't be right. Everybody can't, you know, there's no way every religion is going to this peaceful happy place that they believe in. Like, there's no way. You know? Like, and I've never had a clear-cut answer for that. Because it's kind of hard to really ask anybody that, especially somebody who is, like, you know, they believe in a certain religion. Because, obviously, they just going to say their religion is the right religion. Like, nobody's going to give you, like, a a reason to why what is what. Nobody's going to give you a clear-cut answer and say, well, it's like this because of this, you know? So, how I feel about religion, y'all, I'm going to be honest with y'all. I mainly feel like religion in general, the baseline of it is love for every religion. Because, I mean, I don't really, you know, like I said, I only know about Christianity. And I only know a little bit about others, like not too much. But the baseline seems like to just love and spread peace. Like, that seemed like the baseline core meaning for every religion from what I'm getting. So, yeah, but y'all let me know what y'all think about that, man. Like, y'all, we can have, like, a hard, serious talk about this. Because I really didn't think this video was going to be like this, but, you know, when I saw the title, I was like, okay, it's probably going to be like this. But, yeah, y'all let me know what y'all think, man, because, like I said, every religion can't be right. There's just no way. Anywho,
I showed that I was broken and it's forced me just to only want to hate. Why is it only one you but multiple religions? Why does every conversation end in a division? Why does everybody want to tell us how to live but they won't listen to the same damn message that they give? Tell me,
that's another thing too. Like, a lot of people in certain religions, like, they do that. Like, they preach, oh, you need to do this, you need to do this, you need to do this in these religions. But you go turn around, look at them, they're not preaching what they're talking about. And then on top of that, if you try to ask a question about, like, certain people in their religion, you ask, oh, why is this this? Why is this this? Not only do they get offended, but that causes an argument and leads into a division. Because now, not only did you not even answer the question that was asked, you're not even making the religion welcoming for somebody to want to participate in, you know? So it's like, I don't know, y'all. Like I said, I am a Christian, and I believe in the man upstairs. I believe in angels. I believe in good and evil spirits. I believe in all that. But I've always had questions, like, always. But, yeah.
One you but multiple religions. Why does every conversation end in a division? Why does everybody want to tell us how to live but they won't listen to the same damn message that they give? Tell me how to feel, tell me what's wrong. I tried to call, pick up the phone, I'm on my own. Everybody says you coming back to man, why the hell's it taking so long? Why do I hurt? Why is there pain? Why does everything good always have to change? Why does everybody try to profit off another man's work then destroy it just for monetary gain? Tell me, are you black or are you white? I don't even really care, I just really want to know what's right. They've been saying one thing but I've been looking in the book. It seems like they've been lying for my whole damn life.
Yeah, that's another thing too. Like, I mean, yeah, even in, like, because I could have swore up and down, like, for the longest time, I thought the man upstairs, I thought he was white. Turns out the way the book describes him, they basically say he's saying he's black. So it's like, okay, why was this not said in the church, you know? Like, why was this not, like, it, you know? And then, oh my goodness. Like, y'all, it's so, hold on, I gotta go back a little bit too. Hold on, because Dak says something. Hold on.
Monetary gain. Tell me, are you black or are you white? I don't even really care, I just really want to know what's right. They've been saying one thing but I've been looking in the book and it seems like they've been lying for my whole damn life.
Yeah, it's like, on top of that too, people use, it's like certain religions, people kind of, I feel like they use them for, like, just for views and to say, oh, hey, y'all, I'm in this, but they're not even really acting out in it either. Like, they're not even practicing nothing in the religion. They just got the title. And then they just doing it for views and attention. Like, what? Or, not even on top of that, some people even disrespect other, like, Christianity, for example, gets disrespected to the highest degree, especially amongst, like, the industry of rap or whatever. Like, for the most part, like, the big people, like the top people in the rap game, majority of them are disrespecting some kind of religion. And it seems like it's always Christianity. And it's like, you know, now they got this, not only are they getting backlash, they getting this, like, you know, shock value that's shocking people and making, you know, people watch it. And mind you, people are obviously going to be upset, going to be mad at it, but by that point, they not already did their job. Like, they already got you to click. Once you click on the child, they count as a view. And if y'all know anything about views and, like, YouTube and stuff like that in general, views equate to money. Like, you know, that first view, I mean, that's, you know, well, I think it's the first 1,000 views is like a penny or something like that. Or a dollar. It depends. Because some people, they get 1,000 views, they could be like $5, $10. And then other people, it'd be like just only a dollar or something like that. Maybe 50 cents for some people. But y'all get the point. Once the views start coming in and people click on it, it don't matter how long you stayed on it, you clicked on it. Their work is done. Their job is done. That's it. They didn't disrespect this religion, got you to click on it, and you in the comments voicing your opinion. It don't even matter. They're not gonna even see it. And then if they do see it, they're not gonna say nothing. Cause I mean, at the end of the day, they got their money, y'all. So it's like I don't get it. I don't get it. But I mean, well, I do get it, but it's still like, is it even really worth it at that point?
One thing, but I've been looking in the book, and it seems like they've been lying for my whole damn life. Tell me where I'm going. Is it heaven or hell? I just hope this message reaches you well. Had a dream that I was walking with the devil. Don't remember how it feels, but I swear that I remember the smell. Looked me right into my eye and told me everything I wanted could be mine if I gave up and decided to sell. But I said I'd rather die than get mine. Now I'm here, no fear, one man with a story to tell. Dear God, where were you when I needed it? When I fucked up and repeated it? When they set the bar and I exceeded it? My life is like a book that they've been judging by a cover, but I've never took the time to fucking read this shit. I remember telling you my goals and my dreams, but you didn't even answer, so I guess you didn't believe in it. I remember sitting with a gun to my head trying to ask you for some.
Oh, okay. See, now that's another thing too. Like, I know when people like going through stuff and like they going through like a really, really rough time, a lot of times people do pray and then they think like they're going to immediately get out the situation. One thing I've noticed this, and it's kind of crazy. Like, this is what kind of makes me believe the man upstairs is like, you know, he's real. Cause y'all, every time I've prayed about anything, it could be something simple, like, you know, a new character in a video game, or, you know, like my life turning out this way, or, you know, some like a certain event happening in my life. It's like I've always kind of just like once I did pray, I never freaked out, but I would just be like, okay, well. Hey, man, yeah, it's getting pretty bad. You know, like, that's how, you know, I would, like, if it gets tough, I would pray. But the thing is, I'm a patient person. Like, I'm not someone who's, like, gonna say, you know, well, I'm not gonna, you know, talk to the man upstairs and rush him. Like, I'm not, no, like I said, I'm a patient person. Like, I give y'all an example for how patient I am. Like, say I go to a fast food spot, like Chick-fil-A or something like that, and it's a little pack. I'm the type, some people, a lot of times, if the line is too long, they'll drive away and go somewhere else. Me, I'll sit there, probably turn some music on, chill, or, like, if I'm in the drive-thru, if I'm in the, you know, the actual, like, inside the fast food place, I just wait. I'll be patient and wait. That's just kind of how I always been. Like, I've always been a patient person, so. But I will say, like, everything I prayed for, like, it's always come true in one way or another. And, y'all, I even go a step further. Like, it's gotten so crazy to the point I've had dreams about, like, certain things happening in my life before they happen. And then, in the future, that same dream I had, it actually happens in real life, which is that's the craziest thing. So, I can't even explain that. Like, with YouTube, for example, I've had multiple dreams about YouTube, like, I've had dreams about me being in a mansion. I've had dreams about, you know, a certain specific dollar amounts in my bank account. When I even my bank account, my YouTube, like, it's a thing where YouTube shows you your revenue. I've had dreams about how much that would be in the future, which That, like, it's really crazy. It's really crazy, y'all. Like, so I can't explain that, but I mean, you know, it's clearly some spiritual talking to me and showing me like how life is gonna turn out for me. So yeah, that's why I say I'm just being patient with YouTube and stuff. But I mean, overall, like I said, I would say all my prayers have been answered. But yeah, so.
I don't want religion, I need that spirituality. I don't want a church, I need people to call a family. I don't want to tell my sins to another sinner just because he's got a robe and he went to some academy. I don't want to read it in the book, I want to hear it from you. Don't want to learn it in my school because they're hiding the truth. Don't want to talk about it to another fucking human being, and that's the only reason that I even step in this booth, dear God.
Yeah, I'm kind of the same way. I mean, I will talk religion with other people. Like, I don't mind it, but like I said, a lot of times people not going to... Whatever, like I said, whatever religion they believe in, it's just that's what they gonna stick to. Like everything else is gonna be like shut out, or they gonna dismiss like any other religion, and just tell you specifically about theirs, and not a lot of time not even answer a question you ask. So, you know.
Do I take this darkness and turn it into light? How do I believe in a concept where I speak to a man I've never seen with my own two eyes? How do I know that religion wasn't made just to separate the world and create a whole disguise just to keep us in these chains while the rich get richer and the poor pray to you and perpetuate a lie?
Oh, man. Yeah, that's a big one. That's a big one. You got... That's another thing, too. You got people out here who probably don't even... Who not only don't even practice religion, don't even care about religion, but they're sitting up here rich and they had this glamorous life and don't have a care in the world about what's going on with, like, you know, average regular people or middle class people. Or like they just don't care and they probably never pray, have never prayed a day in their life. But you have people that pray every day, that, you know, faithfully walk in, you know, the man upstairs, you know, word, and they in the Bible, like all that, and they struggling the hardest. And so a lot of people, like, they struggle their whole life like that. Like, a lot of people, a lot of these people, they struggle their whole life like that. And they don't... Y'all, it's people out here that's never going to experience being rich, wealthy, having a good amount of money. Like, I'm talking about, like, six figures. Like, there's a lot of people who have nine and even right now won't experience that. And they religious. So it's like, you know.
Do I know this ain't some big joke? How can I have faith when there is no hope? How the hell does one man have $100 billion and we still have people on the street that are broke?
Exactly. There are men who have hundreds and billions of dollars. Billions. Y'all, not millions, billions of dollars. And there are still people, that are starving, hungry, homeless, people on the streets. And people, then on top of that, the class, like, I don't like saying poor, the poor class, but I mean... That's how people categorize now, unfortunately. Like, you got wealthy, middle class, and then you got, you know, the poor class. But it shouldn't even be a poor class. That's my thing, y'all. That's what I don't like. Like, I'm just say middle class. I feel like even, like, everybody's middle class. Either you middle class or you rich. But, yeah, like, the people that's not fortunate, like, they just struggling check by check. And you have people out here who have millions and billions, billions of dollars. And it's like, it just really makes you wonder, like, damn, like, I mean, you can argue this, that everybody that's in the position they're in is their fault. But at the same time, some people aren't fortunate with certain scenarios. But, okay, I can see how this could be a little tricky, because those people who are rich, they did have to put in a lot of work for that. Even like millionaires too, they did have to put in work for that. Like, I'm not gonna discredit anybody that's rich. But at the same time, it's like, can we at least up minimum wage at least in regular 9-to-5 jobs? Like, yeah, I remember when I was working, I was making $7.25 an hour. Like, you know how crazy that is to hear nowadays? This is why I had to work 2 jobs, by the way. But, like, y'all know how crazy that is? $7.25? And mind you, everything is going up. Everything is going up. Everything. So, yeah, I can't... That's not livable. Even with 2 jobs, I'm barely making rent. So, I mean, y'all do the math, man. Like, that's just, like, come on now. But, I mean, like I said, everybody that's rich, they deserve it because they did have to work for that. So, you can argue kids, if they born into a rich family, but that's another discussion for another day. But, yeah, y'all get the point.
There's a lot of things I want to talk about and get off my chest. I can't sleep because the devil won't let me rest. I used to know a fucking pastor in a church and I can still hear the screams of the kids even fucking molest. Dear God! I'm supposed to fear you, but you ain't said shit. So maybe it's you who actually fears me. I don't know the answer, I just want to see it clearly. So many lies, 1,000 different theories.
Oh my goodness. And then he talked about the pet. Oh my goodness. And then the first time I heard how some pastors really are behind the scenes, y'all, that utterly just blew my mind. Like pastors out here molesting kids? Like, are you, like, a pastor? A pastor, y'all? And you call yourself religious and you're supposed to be preaching the word, but you're doing this behind closed doors?
All I want to know is who really made religion, because I know it wasn't you, but don't nobody believe me. No more lies, no more death. Bring back King. Please, dear God, let their soul rest. Protect who's left and watch their steps. Dear God, I don't want to have to ask you again. I just hope that you know that I'm still a believer. So I'll end this all by saying amen.
Gonna lie, y'all, Dax, he not wrong for feeling like that. He not, because like I told you, I have some similar questions about stuff, and it's like I just feel like they never gonna get answered by like a person. The man upstairs literally has to like tell me himself, like the religion question. Nobody, y'all, let's be for real, who's gonna answer? Nobody is gonna be able to answer this religion question but the man upstairs. Like I said, so far, like, the best signals I've been getting about, you know, him being, the man upstairs being real is, like, all my prayers being answered. Like, not, like, because like I said, when you pray, you can't just expect it to happen just like that. You have to be patient. And dreams, like, me having certain dreams, well, dreams in general. Like, some dreams obviously don't have a meaning, but other dreams, especially when you can remember them clearly and vividly, those are the ones you really kind of want to pay attention to the most. Like, cause I'm pretty sure y'all have had nights where y'all go to sleep and then you just, all of a sudden, you just wake up and it's the next morning. You know, so. But then, other nights you have, like, not only is the dream vivid, it just feel like it's going on for a little minute, too. Like, you in, like, a movie or something, but it's starring you. So y'all know what I'm talking about, so. Those are dreams I definitely pay attention to. And every time I do, like, they always... It's like, for the most part, they always come, like, true. Now, it could be some dreams you remember vividly that still don't have a meaning. Like, it's just a whole bunch of random stuff going on. But, yeah, no. Other than that, yeah, like I said, for the most part, the dreams that, like, actually send messages, well, like I said, predicting my future, like, they've happened. So, I wouldn't be surprised if this, like, little thing on YouTube happens pretty soon, too. So, I'm just being patient, y'all. And the way we going, it seemed like it's going to, you know, happen. But, I'm like I told you, I'm sick of being broke. But, anywho, yeah, it's going to do it, y'all. Let me know y'all thoughts. Let me know what y'all think. More Dax on the way, so y'all stay tuned. And yeah, that's it. Y'all stay safe, stay out of trouble. I love y'all, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Now, bye. The influence, all the times you told me beat it, now you gotta face the music. I'm